from Helen there, the government has just opened its own fund to help community campaigns.
Yes, it's also appointed a sort of pub referee, which is Paul here, to sort out disputes. But Helen reckons that you, Paul, have got a pretty tough job on your hands.
Pub landlord Dave Mountford's a good listener. He needs to be. When not running the Boat Inn in Derbyshire, he advises tenants in dispute with the companies that own their pubs, the so-called pubcos.
I don't ever want anybody to be where I was 5 years ago. And if I can help people to avoid that, I will.
Before moving to the Boat Inn, Dave spent 5 years at another Derbyshire pub, the Rising Sun, as a pubco tenant, but left with mounting debts that would bankrupt him.
You are facing bankruptcy. You are facing all of the emotional impact that has. You feel you've failed your family.
The pubco that own the Rising Sun say Mr. Mountford's dispute with them is long since settled and in no way representative of their current business model. In most tenanted pubs owned by pubcos and breweries, the landlords have to buy their beer from them at fixed, higher prices. Unlike the Rising Sun, the Boat is a free house, so Dave can buy his drink wherever he wants.
Up here, a pint of Pedigree sells for around £3. As a free of tie tenant, Dave pays about £1 for it, which gives him £2 profit. If he were tied, therefore had to buy the beer from his pub company, he would pay about 80 pence a pint more. Cheers, Dave.
Dave now campaigns for the abolition of the beer tie and has negotiated on behalf of around 50 other unhappy pubco tenants.
There is no partnership at all. It is a purely one-sided agreement. Quite often we can do nothing more than hold their hand as they kind of slide into financial oblivion. But in many cases we can actually get results for them.
Working with pubcos and breweries works well for many tenants. But in 2011, MPs on the Business Innovations and Skills Select Committee concluded that the beer tie and high rents were causing pubs to close. The industry said it would change. Yet in 2014, the Campaign for Real Ale said the odds were still stacked against tenants.
Well, it shows there was an inequality between the way in which the large pub-owning companies, the pubcos, were acting towards their tenants. Put simply, they were seeking to make too much money from the relationship, in our opinion, and maintaining many of the tenants in a position of poverty, frankly.
For 10 years until 2005, this man worked for pubcos large and small. While no longer employed by pubcos, he doesn't want to be identified, as he still works in the hospitality industry and fears for his employment. He says a rapid turnover in tenants, or churn as it's called in the business, was simply accepted.
The tenants were just cannon fodder. If landlords did a good job and were successful, then after 2 or 3 years the rent will be increased, and that is when the problems will begin. Hard-working landlords would find it almost impossible to make a living.
This is a confidential online forum where landlords can seek advice and support from each other.
There are hundreds of stories on here of struggling tied tenants.
Pubcos say it's simply not in their interest to see tenants struggle. Bridget Simmons heads the British Beer and Pub Association.
The pub tie is a unique way, a low-cost entry into running your own business. And it is a partnership with the pub company. And the pub company supports you, they'll provide marketing support, they'll provide a lot of capital investment, about 200 million a year from our companies. And they really want you to succeed at the end of it.
A new law coming in next month, the Pub Code, is aimed at ensuring tied tenants get a fairer deal. The pub code will mean as agreements come up for review, tenants will be able to leave the beer tie and negotiate a fair market rent.
How have the pub codes responded to the new legislation?
We will respect the new legislation. We didn't like statutory legislation, but we will look forward to working with the pub's adjudicator. We have a voluntary system that's been there for many years. We'll be building on that and we accept it.
So, a decade after it was first mooted, will the pub code mean tenants can pull pints without one hand tied behind their back?
So, Paul Newby is the newly appointed pubs adjudicator, and I'm rightly informed that your drink of choice is a pint of foaming ale.
Thank you, Matt.
Just slightly short of a pint there, Suggs, but I'm sure we'll let that one go.
I've got the foaming bit. I've got it to foam.
Yeah, you might want to wait till the end of the interview to drink this.
Yes,
yeah, maybe.
Okay,
it doesn't
yes.
look
Thank
brilliant, does it?
Thank you.
Now, we should stress, Paul, that many tied pubs operate without any disputes at all, and some don't work because simply they're not very well managed and run. However, a report commissioned by Camera in 2013 found that 20% of pub co-tied licensees were earning £15,000 or more each year, which is a very small sum. Now, if there are any of those people watching out there, what would be your message to them then?
Well, look, tenants work very, very hard. They work very long hours, and they should be able to earn a decent living.
Yes.
I think that must be very clear in all of this. So what is my job about? What's the code about? It's to create a better and fairer relationship, to look at if they exist, to look at imbalances in the big pub co small tenant relationship and deal with those. I suppose in a nutshell, where they exist, it's really to achieve a level playing field and where necessary to provide some protection for tenants.
Yeah, and a role that I'm sure you agree is really well needed. I mean, I know quite a few landlords that have fallen victim of this, and you know, the stories that we heard in the film there. But how strict can you be with these pub companies, and how can you be sure that they're not going to kind of recuperate that money in other ways?
Well, the code addresses this issue in a number of ways.
Right.
And let's be clear, if there are... We don't know how those might come at us at the moment, but if there are unfair practices out there, then the code is meant to deal with those.
Right. Right. And how strict can it be?
Well, I think it can be very strict if it needs to be.
Yeah.
We'll wait and see. I mean, as you've said, there are parts of the trade where the relationship is quite good.
Yeah.
But there are clearly other parts that are not.
Yeah.
And I want to make sure that those parts that are not are properly looked at.
Now, some people may say, Paul, that your CV suggests, i.e. your relationship with pub companies, may suggest that you'd find it hard to be fair and impartial in this case. So how are you going to take that forward then?
OK, well, yeah, I mean, I am concerned about these comments, and I really don't want them to get in the way of this code being properly implemented.
Was it right you used to sell properties that were pubs to be developed as
Well, yes, let me be clear about that. Let me say that I've got huge respect for all the people that have worked so hard to get this code, and I absolutely want nothing that's going to get in the way of that. So I need to work on this area. Yes, I've never worked for a pub company. But yes, in my last role, I worked for a company that gave some advice to pub companies. But let me be clear, I also gave an awful lot of advice to tenants as well.
Yeah.
And
well, it's good that you know how both sides
That's
work.
The point. Yeah. You know, I'm coming from this in the round.
Yeah.
I'm able to look at it from all sides.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I want to use that to help me implement the code.
And actually, with that experience in mind then, I mean, how worthwhile are these campaigns that we're hearing about tonight?
Well, I think this proves it, doesn't it? I mean, the attention that has been achieved in all of this is absolutely fantastic. The pub is really important part of British life. You know, history, culture, our social lives. We all want to see pubs thrive.
Yeah,
and this code is an important part in the pub co-tenant market. It's an important part of helping pubs survive and thrive.
So you don't think they're unrealistic then? And you think that number that we mentioned, 27 a week, that will be different next year that are closing?
Well, let's hope so.
And, or we'll and get you back, Paul.
Well, yeah.
come back
and have another pint of foaming ale.
Good stuff.
All right, thanks, Paul.
Thank you very much.
Well, as well as
the
foaming ale, I mean, you've got to have a few nibbles as well, haven't you, when you go down the pub. We've got some pickled eggs on the go here. We've got some pork scratchings. How are the sausage rolls? Good?
Going.
Yeah, go.